HCR channel. Today we are discussing about the English subject. In English, first we take the topic of parts of speech. In the parts of speech, every time we see that the noun is a first one. So we also take the noun first. So let's see the noun. What is noun? A noun is used to identify a class of people, places, things, or to name a particular one of this. Every time a noun means, what is noun? We raise a question. The noun is knowing about a particular people, particular place, or a particular thing's name. Okay. Next we see, in the noun we are having six different types. So let's see, what are that six different types of nouns? The first one is common noun. Okay. The next one is proper noun. And the third one of the nouns is concrete noun. And then the fourth one is abstract noun. And here, the fifth one is collective noun. And the last one of the noun is count and mass noun we see. So, now, first one we know that common noun. Second one is proper noun. Third one is concrete noun. Fourth one is abstract noun. Fifth one is collective noun. And the sixth one is count and mass noun. Let me explain you about all these six nouns. Okay. First one is common noun. So, what is common noun? A common noun is the generic name for a person, place, or thing. Here, generic means a commonly used name is called generic. So, common noun means a common noun is the generic name for a person, place, or thing. For example, we use a boy, a girl. The boy and the girl are commonly used names. Okay, next. The second one is proper noun. A proper noun means the name given to something to make it more specific. Common noun means which is commonly used. Proper noun means which is used very specifically. For example, we take two names, Radha, Ravi. These two names are mainly caused to be specifically. And also a place and a thing. A Delhi is a specific place which has one name, and the table is also specifically we are calling the same that, and these two names are also we are calling them very specifically. When we see here in common noun, the boy and girl, if we call anyone a boy and a girl, then we see that both names are similarly and commonly used. But here, when we come to proper noun, these names are not commonly used. So, this is the difference between common noun and proper noun. Next, the third one is concrete noun. What is mean by concrete noun? A noun denoting a material object rather than an abstract quality, state, or action is called a concrete noun. For example, we take a building or a tree. Let's revise once more. What is mean by concrete noun? A noun denoting a material object rather than an abstract quality, state, or action is called concrete noun. Okay, next we go to the fourth one. Abstract noun. A noun denoting an idea, quality, or state rather than a concrete object. For example, humble and truthworthy. Humble and truthworthy are belongs to quality. So here, once you observe, a noun denoting an idea, quality, or state rather than a concrete object is called abstract noun. Next, here, concrete noun and abstract noun. What is difference between this both? Here in concrete noun, there is a material object rather than an abstract quality, state or action. But here in abstract noun, we can see a noun denoting an idea or quality or state rather than a concrete object. Here we can see of abstract quality, which is rather than an abstract quality, and here rather than a concrete object. Okay, so next one is collective noun. A collective noun is a collection of things taken as whole. I think you can understand a collective noun is a collection of things taken as whole. For example, we take a group of people and a group of kittens, a group of dogs, and we can take many examples for collective noun. Okay, now let's go to count and mass noun here. The count and mass noun. What is different between count as noun and mass noun? First we see count noun. If you can put number with fingers, means if you are able to count with our fingers, it is called countable noun. And next one, mass noun that cannot be pluralized. Mass noun means the things which we cannot count. Means the mass noun is undefined. The mass noun is also called as uncountable and non-countable noun. So for example, we take for countable noun and mass noun. The countable noun example is 3. Just we take an example. And a lot of numbers which we can count by our fingers. And next, mass noun examples are undefined. Why it is undefined means because mass noun means uncountable noun. Uncountable means we cannot count forever with our fingers or without anything. With anything, we can't count. That is called mass noun or uncountable. So we take example it as undefined. Okay friends, thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe SGR channel. Thank you very much.